Today is the pilot test for your first group of the pilot group of whereby you selected your own user for the pilot test.
Yep.
Okay, so throughout these sessions, I'll pass the sessions to you and at the end, you will actually, today we will not have a feedback for yourself, but we will get the feedback from your audience.
So how is everybody doing?
Yeah, we are still working from home.
Oh yeah, but in UM we are still at home for the most part. So we are waiting for the signal from the university management.
Hello.
To either start going to office. And what the arrangement is, we don't really know yet.
Yeah. And your audience are very active. They are chatting in the chat. Perhaps you can have a look.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so actually the audience are a mixture of a few groups of users that I have selected for the, what you call the, program. They are in different categories, I would say. So one is the academic champions. We also have the academic departments, administration departments, research groups. So these are the four groups that I foresee that will be able to benefit the most from using of of teams in the university.
Dr. Zahir, do you think after these sessions, would you be able to give us a list of the participants with their departments respectively, just for us to take note on the departments that are involved in this pilot test?
Actually, it's in the OneNote notebook.
It's exactly as the one that you write in your earlier plan?
Yes.
Okay, no problem.
No, that one. And even categorize it that way.
Okay, then I will just refer to that. We have 21 here, including us, so deduct on.
All right, so do you want to start first? Introduce yourself.
Maybe just start an introduction on who are us. I mean, Fidelis as the program mentor. Okay, so I believe everyone, others, audience also, they're actually first time meeting us. So my name is Mei Wan. I'm the program manager for this team coach program. So basically, this is an 8-week teams coach program that we are actually going through with Dr. Zahir. And today is the fourth week. Fourth week is under the pilot test. So we will have all of you here to involve together with Dr. Zahir. So he will actually conduct this workshop to everyone. And we will be here actually monitoring the progress, and also if there's any questions or any technical issues whereby you face during your trying out on Teams, you can also raise it here. You can either raise it up on your mic, or you can also actually put it out in the chat. You can try to respond to the chat when Dr. Zahir is presenting. I believe because he's busy on the presentation, so we can actually take note on some of the questions or inquiry raised up by your audience. And during throughout the sessions, we prefer that you actually mute your mic for those who is not presenting. Okay. I would like to also introduce my team here together with me. I have Amil here. Amil is the trainer. Is a mentor for this program. So he is the one who actually trained Dr. Zahir and provide him with the advice on how to carry out this program in the school. Amil, can you show your face?
Sorry? Show my face? Oh.
Yeah, yeah, just okay. The introduction because everyone haven't seen us before.
Okay.
Should we... comment to show your face?
Oh, sorry. Hello everyone. Good afternoon.
OK, Okay, so Amir will be, he has gone through actually 3 weeks of program with Dr. Zahil on the past 3 weeks, and we have actually go through most of the features under Microsoft Teams. And today is the day that Dr. Zahil will actually conduct this workshop to the audience, the first group of people in the school. These are the people here. We have about 20 of you. And you guys are being addressed as a pilot test group. So next, I have also Johnny here. Johnny is our project manager. So he is his expertise is more on technical side and also some of the matters related to SharePoint. Johnny, are you here? Johnny. I think he is not here yet. Okay, maybe we skip first. And also I have Atira here. Atira is doing the coordinations on the whole program. Atira, are you able to show your face? And together here we have our actually our leader, Miss Linda, and she actually she is the one who actually engaged Microsoft for the program. Linda, are you here?
Hi everyone, good afternoon. Yes, thank you for participating in this pilot test. I hope give us more feedback, right, and more chat questions and answer will be delivered by our team here for improving the team's usage together with Dr. Zahil. We hope that later on you can add in your feedback into our forms, right? We will improve together with doctor together, right? After this program, we will actually build a team site and hopefully we can ready and use it and deploy to the school for your this coming usage in the school. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Linda. Okay, so today is the first workshop, and I'm not sure whether all of you are actually aware, we have a next session during the week six. Week number six is actually under teachers enablement. So we will have another similar session targeting on teachers on how to utilize the teaching and learning tools in Microsoft Teams. So without further ado, I will pass the sessions back to Dr. Zahil to start the sessions. Dr. Zahil.
Hello, everybody. So good afternoon. I'm sharing my screen now. Can you see the screen?
Yes.
So as Maywan and the team through the program just now, so I was engaged actually by Microsoft and also by the Federalist team to start the team's coaching program, so that then we can further utilize or maximize the use of the Office 365 account that we have in our institution. So I actually have one previous workshop on Teams, I think 3 weeks back. So that is the introduction session, and that was open. So now it's more on a focused group, I would say, to look at different categories that can use Office 365 for the university. So when thinking about the program, what I find out or what I thought about is we have actually about four groups that can further utilize Teams properly as a university. So, and these are the academic champions, so these are the teachers mostly, and then academic departments, so that would actually be people like faculties and also departments within the university itself, so in the academic PTJs, to use Office 365 as well as Teams and also SharePoint for their work. And then we have the administration department, so those are officers outside of academic PTJs. We have representative from TNCA's office, so Encik Azbullah. So, and also we are also looking at other similar types of organization within University Malaya to use Teams that way. And we also have the research groups. So the research groups is one of the, I think, the best avenues to use Teams with university, the university account, because we have enabled a few features within Teams to enable like a big research initiative to be run and also managed using Teams. Okay, so maybe some of you have gone through the similar or slightly similar slide before, but I have made a few tweaks here and there. So for the first timers, enjoy the ride. For the ones who probably have been have looked at the slide before, actually there are a few additions that I have gained. And that was gained through the three previous week that I was being coached by the team at Microsoft. So again, the synopsis for this will be to explore the Office 365 environment available to university and also staff. It's actually quite a unique account that we have because some other universities, they set up their office differently. The Office 365, they set it up differently so that their students cannot link to their teachers. So there are I think at least one university has done that, but we fortunately have put the host for students and also for our staff in a similar host. So that means that we can link with our students. So that is one good thing about it. And then in the course of a few discussions with Microsoft and also discussions with TM, we also enabled guest access into Teams. And we enable guest access so that then people from different universities, for example, if you are doing research and you have a research group, so that you can invite the researchers from that different university using their university account or official account to join and manage the research group from our Teams. So that is some feature or the feature that I really like using in Teams. And we are also going to look at how to collaborate in Teams so that then it makes your life easier, it makes the work more efficient and also more connected. And then we are going to look at also how we manage the filing inside Teams. And then I'm going to also look at or show you what Teams can do in SharePoint, which I learned only very, very recently from the team helping me. Okay, so let me move on. Okay, so so this is the sort of learning outcomes. You can't really run away from that because you're at university. So this will be the sort of our learning outcome for today. So you'll be able to manage the course files, collaborate on faculty and departmental work, and also manage the research student and research group. And I'm doing that with my research student. And then get the students to learn efficiently and collaboratively in and out of the classroom, especially now when we are working from home and the students are learning from home. And also to create documents that resides on the cloud so that then you can access them anytime or anywhere. Okay, so what is Office 365? So these are for the newcomers. So it's actually a collection of Office suite that we normally buy in software form for ourselves, but we get the account that is paid for by the university, by the government, that allows us to do work inside Office 365 environment, and it allows us to actually create online documents and work on the online documents and then collaborate on the online document. So that is what we like about it. And it is always up to date. So you, when you download your Office 365, it's actually the latest version. And with your account, you get actually 5 licenses. So that means one license, one copy of the software, of course, in your Office PC, and then one another license would go to probably now when you are working from home, your home PC, and then another to your laptop, so you can download that to the laptop, and then you have probably you want to enable it in your wife's or partner's or husband's laptop, so that is another one, and then you have another one that you can probably open it up in your father or your in-laws house. So you have 5 licenses so that then you can download and use the Office 365 anywhere you are. Anywhere you are. Okay, and it's all on your device. You can actually download it a copy to your tablet or to your iPads or to your phone, and when you download on your phone, it does not count into the 5, so that would be unlimited. The thing that you need to do is you need to just make sure that you log in with your Office 365 account, which is the Office 365, your username, and then at 365.um.edu.my. So that is what you just need to do, and then of course everything is on the cloud. So with the license comes all the productivity tools that comes with the Microsoft, suite. You have also 1 terabyte of storage in the personal OneDrive. So 1 terabyte is actually quite big. My laptop is only 512 gigabyte. Normally, modern desktop PCs will have normally 1 terabyte of storage, and you get that 1 terabyte as well for yourself. So you potentially can actually upload or keep everything that's in your desktop in the storage in OneDrive, 1 terabyte storage. And of course, with the license comes the Office 365 email. So that's a secondary email that you can fall back to in case you need to use it. Okay, so actually there are various types of teams for education. So I'm going to share this slide with you. Let me check where is it. Okay, so I'm going to share this page. Okay, so this is the different types of Office 365 teams and channels that you can use for education. So the link is given in the slide. First, of course, there are different types of teams that's available. So it's a class teams. That means it's for class. So it comes with education license that comes with a class. It will give you assignments, and also so that is something that you can use. Of course, we are still using Spectrum, and that can be, so this can be like a fallback or an alternative platform for you to do your class, or you manage your class and assignments. And then we also have the professional learning communities. So that is for educator working group. This is for any group work that you might have, probably for the research group, it can be used, we can use this. And then we also have the staff teams. So that would be useful or can be beneficial for the departments and also the faculties. So we have 2 departments, academic departments and non-academic departments. You can use staff type for teams, and also you have also the research groups that can use a professional learning community. And of course, if for example the students wants to create their own study groups or clubs, they can use the other type. Okay, and within The teams, there will be channels, so I will show what channels are later. But basically, it will be the same as what I have created in the Office 365 Learning Community teams that I've created for you guys. Okay, and then we have several scenarios that teams that can be utilized for our use or in our academic use. Microsoft has actually given like a sample of what kind of teams that can be created. So you have teams like a school board or Department of Education or large scale education initiative. So this could be something that's bigger, probably beyond our scope. Okay, but we, I think, can actually work on this. So school leadership, so that can be actually the faculties in themselves. So what can the faculties can do? So superintendent means would be translated as actually the dean, and then we have the support staff and also the head of departments. So these are the teams for, and then you also have different channels for the faculty meetings, and then you can have channels to show progress on objectives and projects. Okay, and also we have departments. So this is as what our departments in the faculties can do. So it can be, instead of school departments, it can be our programs. So the programs can use the team this way. So you have your professional development, you have the learning outcomes, you can do curriculum reviews in teams, and it collects together the leaders and also the lecturers within the same teams. So this is what you can do. You can save time, reduce unproductive email chains, and you can actually go through this later. I will share this link in our teams later. Okay, you can also have schools and also educational technology group, the IT department, teacher PLC or professional learning communities, and you also have options to do classes. So those are the kinds of teams that you can use for the purpose. Okay, so let me share the slide again. So this is the older slide. Let me change that. Okay, so bear with me for a moment. Okay, so where were we? Okay, so I'm going to jump right into the first part that I want to show teams is. So I'm actually jumbling the departments and also the program, so don't worry about it, but we are going to cover the whole spectrum or the whole scope in this training up until 5 o'clock. So first, what you can do with teams is you can actually manage your research students and also research groups. Okay, so normally we do research not singularly, so that means we have a research team, so we have a research group. It can be also in a cluster, for example. So you can actually create a cluster teams, and then the cluster can have its own research group as channel. So there are many ways that you can work this. And what it does is actually, this is a chat-based workspace in Office 365 environment. And what it can do is you can actually have conversations within the teams, and you can also keep files in there. So when you keep your files online, when you create and keep the files online for especially the research group and research students, you don't risk losing files in case of, for example, somebody's laptop blew up, or somebody left their laptop in the airport, for example, on the way to meetings or conferences. So since everything is created online and it is created within the teams itself, the files are still going to be stored there, and it's going to remain there as long as the group is around. And if, for example, you need to do edits, everybody will know on the edits, okay? And if, for example, you have different versions of the program, for example, a research report, the different versions will always be saved in the Teams. So what happens is you will be able to go back and revert to an earlier version of a report or a document that you have in your team. So that is through the versioning of the files in team. So that is something that's quite useful, and it has been useful for our department's teams before in building building surveying department. So we have used this, and we also can manage our research student and research group. In my own experience, I'm actually a member of several research group that uses Teams. One is actually a member of a research group from University of Nottingham, so they invited me into their Teams, and I became a member of the research group at University of Nottingham's Teams account. So that is, I think Dr. Yu Kong is also a member of that research group, so he can also vouch for that, and also Dr. Hui Min is also here. So that is one more advantages of using and managing teams in the research group. Okay, so and so this is an example of my research. So this is a work that we are doing with the Erasmus Plus project. So this is the ATM Erasmus Plus project, and we keep most of our documents in Teams, so that then all the team members can actually go in and find the documents, can refer to it, and also can use it as a template for them to create claims and reports and others. So that is how you manage the Teams. You can also check out documents. So I'm going to show you how the checkout documents and what checkout documents do is it locks the document from being replaced or being renewed, but it will allow the user of the document to create a copy of the document. So for example, you check out a template for mileage claim or for a research project, for a research report. So you check out that document, and whenever you wanted to use that document, it becomes a new document that you can save in your team. So that is something that is quite useful, I find, and quite interesting in using Teams. Okay, Dr. Yu Kong just messaged in our chat saying that for the Nottingham teams, we need to switch accounts. Yes, we do need to switch accounts if we move or we open a different teams that you were invited in. So that is how that works. Okay, move on. So actually, when you have teams in the class, what you can do is you can actually get the students to work on the online document, and they would what they do. So this is an example of my class. What they do is they create the document, and then they invited me to review and to look at the documents. So if you look at the right hand side of this PowerPoint document, so it version history works both in PowerPoint and in also in other types of Microsoft Suite documents, so Word, Excel, and also PowerPoint. So you can see actually who did what, and that can count as an evidence for the students who are doing their work. So you know that sometimes you get the students to do group work, and they submit files to you, but you don't know that was this document is done by a single person, or was it done by different person, the member of the group. So looking at the version history gives you a glimpse of how the document was created by the group, by the students, and who's working on it. So it's some sort of a validation that the students are actually working in a group. So if you look at the names in the version history that I have opened up just now, it's actually in a matter of about half an hour. So from 10, from 9, half past 9 to about 10, 5 past 10. 10 past 10. And you see that there are different people who are working on the group during that half an hour period. So it shows that the work is done by together by the group. Okay, and you can actually scroll down and to look at, say, who actually created the document, who then worked on it, which gives you one is the collaboration aspect of the group work that you want, and you see it that way. And you see how the document develops. So first, for example, they started with a fact, and then maybe somebody added to the fact, and somebody then do fact check. So those are the kinds of insight that you can get from looking at the version history. It's not just to actually revert back to a different version or an earlier version. You can actually do that. Look at the how the document evolves when it was done collaboratively by the students. So this is another example of that. So similar. So this is actually a student's presentation actually, and they did it for my class. And you see that the name is actually the name of the students. So this is a document that's created by the students and then shared with me as a teacher. Okay, and then so this is actually where the document is shared to me. So this is actually our Spectrum page, and what I did is I create a forum, and students actually wrote in the forum, wrote a piece of text, and also link the document that they created in Office 365 using the Office 365 account that they have. So that allows almost seamless integration between what we have in Spectrum with Teams, and students can use both. They can use the Teams to work collaboratively in the classroom, but at the same time still use our e-learning platform to evidence their learning and also to submit their work. So the submission becomes some sort of attendance for them in our situation right now. Okay, so and again, what you can do, as I said before, you can create cloud-based documents. So cloud-based documents, that means you don't have to save anything in your desktop PC or laptop, and you create the document within the Teams environment itself. So this is actually the Teams for my research group, and when you click on the new button on the top, under the title, it will allow you to create either a document, Word document, Excel workbook, OnePoint presentation, or PowerPoint presentation, OneNote notebook, and also forms for Excel. So forms is similar to Google Forms, and it's using the forms module within Office 365. So when you create the documents online, when you create the documents on the cloud, it stays there. So you don't have to worry about downloading it. So if, for example, you are working with an older computer with limited hard drive space, of course, if you download everything, then it will eat up your space. And this happens to me or to actually our department when one person from our department accidentally deleted the whole Dropbox folder with all our files, all our curriculum review, almost all of our curriculum review files, because the Dropbox account that this person has is downloaded into his PC, and his PC just is running out of space. So by creating the documents in Teams using the Word document, you don't have the risk of that happening to the document. And we see that actually when we work with Google Docs, isn't it, and we upload Word document into Google Docs, what happens is all the formatting just went. It is gone. You get whole sentences without space. The formatting is just horrendous. Is if you upload a Word document into a Google Docs or Google folder. So it using Teams and using the Office 365 environment actually helps you not to have to run into that problem. So because it's a native app, that means it works in Word itself, and when you open Word, it will actually open with the right format for the students for people who are reading the document. Okay, I'm going to have one simple exercise that we have that we are doing right now. So if you could go to the bit.ly document that I've created. Okay, so this bit.ly document is actually resides in my personal OneDrive. Okay, my personal Office 365 OneDrive created given by UM. You can click on the link, or you can type the word. Okay, and you will find that actually within that, it's already being the link has been removed. So let's click on the I'll give you a different link. I will give you a different link in the chat. Okay, probably I forgot to check the link just now, so it's, because this is actually a bit.ly link. Let me share the document again. Okay. Any questions while I open up the documents? Anybody wants to ask anything?
There are some questions on the chat, but we already answered most of them. Some of the answer, some of the question is, what's the difference between guests? What guests can do, something like that.
Mm-hmm. So let me find that document. Is it? Oops, not that one. Oh, Ah, okay. So the link to the document is in actually the chat, the meeting chat column. Okay, you can click on the link, and there is actually people already typing in there. But you can actually just go in and start typing. So just say anything. Just type hello. Today is. Fourth of twenty. Oops. Okay. So I see that people are already typing in there, and you can actually see from the word online, everybody is typing, isn't it? So that is how cool this is. It will be similar to the Google Docs, but then remember, you don't have to worry about the format just running. And you can do this with your students. And normally what I do with students when I ask them to do work in any documents is for them to create the document. They have to create the document and they have to share it with me. So I don't really have to create any documents with the students. Even for example, if I want them to do a long report, I get them to create the document and then share the link with me while they are creating the document. And I can see the report from the students develop using Word, which is something that is great, because then I would be able to see who's working with it. And remember, we have the version history to say, okay, so who's doing this part, who's doing that part. So you know, it's when it is a group work, you know it's actually a group work. Okay, four research groups or four academic department or for a department in the university, you can share this account or share this Word document with your when you create a document, you share it with the people who needs to edit with you. So it no more that you need to create a draft and then email it to your colleague, and then have your colleague work on it and then email it back to you. And it's a very risk that you might get a different version, and then that version will not be the same as what you worked on. And that allows you to actually pinpoint what can be done in the document. And remember, with the version history, especially the version history, we know that, so these are the work that the student or that our work our colleague has done, and we can actually use the comments feature to get them to review or repair certain elements of the work that they are doing. So collaborative cloud-based document works in many ways. It works for the students, and also it works for office work, and it also works for the research groups. So it can work in many angles. Okay, so we are going to move on into a live demo on Teams. So I'm going to show how we create Teams and we create channels, how we add internal and external team members to control members' permission, and enabling emojis, GIFs, and stickers, and then adjusting our personal setting and chat. So I see that some people have their profile picture in here, some don't have their profile picture in here. So So hopefully by the end of the day, at least you will get your profile picture on your own Office 365 profiles. Okay, so let's move on to a live demo team. So okay, so I have, well, before that, I look at two questions here. Number one is from Dr. Abdullah Al-Hadi. So he said that, will it save documents history, like if a student copy and paste? Can we identify it? Well, I think you can try that out. I'm not sure whether it copies where the students copy and paste. Okay. And also, some of them might be copy pasted. I'm not sure. So that is something that we need to check out. So probably somebody from Microsoft can relate to that question. And then the second question is from Puhan. So can you explain again on document checkout? So again, document checkout, what it does is actually when you check out a document, it is locked for editing. So you cannot edit the document again. If you decided you want to edit the document, it will ask you to save it in a different version. So and that document has been checked out. So that is how checked out works. So I think when looking at the way that checkout is a function, the module is functioning, you can use it for templates. So that means you create a template that you want people to copy over and over again. So you create the template and you check the document out. So once, for example, if you are doing students SLT, okay, you work with the template that is given by QMAC, for example, and the template is empty. So after the person or the coordinator for the curriculum review upload the document into the Teams, he or she then checks out the document. So what happens if, for example, this person or this lecturer wants to create his SLT for his course code, when he working on it, when he save, it will save it into a different version. So it will not mess with the checked out document. So that is what checked out means. Okay. And then Dr. Aniriza is asking about the designations are outdated. Yes, okay. So actually the designation is actually controlled by PTM. Probably somebody from PTM will need to actually make sure that the information is updated. I'm actually still a fellow in Teams. So, but it doesn't really, to me, it doesn't really matter. Okay, so, and then Caroline is asking about switching organizations. So, the question is, need to view UM's Teams? Yes. Exactly. So, of course, the desktop version and even the online version, the web version, it can view only one organization at a time. So that means if you need to switch your Teams, what you need to do is you need to go and click on the organization name on the normally top right hand corner of your desktop or the web version, and you can actually switch from different Teams. Okay, so let's look at a live demo on Teams for we are going to do this. So I'm going to show you first, and then I'm actually in the next slide you need to actually create your own Teams. Okay. So let's look at a live demo on Teams on creating Teams and channels, and also adding internal members and a few other things. Okay, so let's let me share you this screen. Okay, so this is actually the document that we are working on just now. Okay, so let's open up Teams page. Okay. So this is actually the Teams that I have created for all of you. You can see this page, isn't it? because I'm sharing this this page right now. Okay, so this is the team that I've created for our group. So it's a UM Office 365 learning community. So you see that I actually changed the logo for it, and then I have different channels for the different categories. Okay, and we have a general channel. So to create teams on Office 365, it's quite easy. If you are in Microsoft Teams, what you do is you click on at the bottom left hand corner here, join or create a team. So what you do is click on that button, and then there are actually two options: create a team or join a team code. And these are all actually open teams that was created by people within University Malaya, and they created an open team, so that's why we can see it here. Then you can actually choose to join the team. But what we are going to do is we are going to create a team. Okay, so this is a demonstration. So let's create, for example, so let's go with the staff. Okay, so that means this is a teams for a faculty or a department within the university. Okay, so for example, it can be office, TNCA office, or it can be faculty of dentistry, for example, or it can be also department of architecture, or department of history. Okay, so let's name this as faculty of let's give it a faculty that is not in UM. So let's say faculty of so I don't have an idea. So faculty, we already have faculty of business. What faculty that we don't have in UM? Okay, faculty of agriculture. Okay, hopefully we don't have faculty of agriculture in UM. Okay, so definition, so this is optional. You can actually put in, say, for example, office work for okay. So the privacy is quite important. So just now you see a public team. So if it's a departmental team or a faculty team, of course you want to make it private. Okay, and then so you give it a name, and then you click on next. Okay, then the system will create the team for you, and of course you will need to add people. Okay, for example, if you are the AR or the deputy dean of the faculty, and you want to add your dean, so you just type in the dean's name. Okay, for example, let's say okay, so let's say it will be okay, so this will be one of the member. Okay, and then I'm going to add also. Okay, and so this is just for show. So let's say, and okay, so these are the four members of the Faculty of Agriculture. Okay, so we add this people, and here you can actually change the designation of these people. It can be a member or it can be an owner. Okay, a member can add, I think, another member, but the owner can delete and do a little bit more with the account that they have. So let's say, for example, I'm making Dr. Elsa as one of the owners, and the rest will be the members of the faculty. Okay, so now we have created this team for the Faculty of Agriculture. Okay, of course the Faculty of Agriculture is non-existent in UM. Okay, so you have created the faculty, Okay, and then if you need to add more member, so you just click on add member, and let's say for example I'm adding a few more people as the staff at the faculty. Okay, so these are now the members of faculty of agriculture, and of course you can actually change the icon for that. So what you do is you click on edit team. Okay, you can, so since it's agriculture, so let's put a picture of the yeah, okay, nice. All right, so oh, camping, no, okay, let's do it with the leaf. Okay, so now you have Faculty of Agriculture with the logo of leaf. Okay, so that is what you can do with it. Okay, you can add members to it, and now you see that you have a few things that you see in there. Okay, so that is one of the way that we can work, or we can use the faculty or the teams to do our work. So let me see what else do I want to share with you just now. Oops. Okay, let me open it up this way so that then it will not be too many opening and closing of documents. Let me open it up in my folder. Okay, so bear with me for a bit. Okay, let me share the screen with you again. Oops, this one. Yes, okay. So what else did I need to, I wanted to share with you? Okay, so we've created the teams. Okay, so now how do we create channels inside our teams is by clicking on the three dots next to the name of the faculty or the name of the team, and you click on add channel. Okay, so channel is for example school of what else? In the Faculty of Agriculture, probably we will have a school of farming. Okay, and you can actually change the privacy setting here. So let's leave it as standard for now. Okay, you can also enable automatically show this channel in everyone's channels list. I'm not going to do that just now. Okay, and I'm going to add one more channel. Okay, for example, so the general channel will consist of everybody. Okay, school of farming, you can actually limit it to different people. So let's add another channel. So of what else? Forestry. Okay, so yeah, school of forestry, and the school of forestry, I want to make it private only for the forestry department members only. Okay, so that channel is only for forestry department. So, and of course you need to add the people in there. So it can be, for example, let's pick up a few more names from the from our guest list. Okay, so it needs to be people from the Faculty of Agriculture. So yeah, so let's put Dr. Farid here as a member of the School of Forestry. Okay. Okay. So you see now, the School of Forestry has a lock on it. So that means it's a private channel within the teams of Faculty of Agriculture. Okay, so that is how you add members internal and external. You can actually add guests from outside by opening again add members, and you type in and organize somebody from a different organization using their official email. Let's say, for example, you have people from UPM in there. So that means it can be. So let's create a name. So Karim at upm.edu.my. Okay. So this person Karim is going to go in the department as a guest. Okay. So this will be useful actually when you create the research group departments or research group teams. So you can add your collaborators from different universities or different agencies. For example, you have somebody from the United Nations. You can add them into your teams as part of your research group. So it enables them to work on the document that you are working together in the same research group, and you don't really have to worry about, again, losing documents and also other kinds of stuff like that. Okay, so of course this is just a made up name, so I'm not going to add this person because it might be actually a real person in UPM that we don't know of. Okay, so that is how you control the permission. Okay, another way for you to control the permission is actually if you go to the manage team, okay, and members and guests. Okay, so we see now, so these are the members and you can actually change the role from either owner to member. So guest members will not be able to do, I don't think they can delete anything in there. They can work on it, they can work together in the team, but they cannot delete things in the teams. Okay, so I can actually show you, since I'm actually a member of this. So this is actually the teams from the University of Nottingham for a project that we are working on. So of course I cannot show you the inside of the files or anything, but this is actually a teams at University of Nottingham that I'm a member of. So let's go back. Okay, so what can you do in your teams? Okay, so of course this the request is when people ask to join your team, so you can actually get the guest to join the team using the guest access. You need to allow them to join your teams using this. Okay, so let's go to the Faculty of Agriculture general teams. Okay, so let me click on that. Okay, so now you can actually start mentioning people with access to the team. So for example, I'm going to ask Dr. Chiam. Okay, here, can you please share with us the files from the forestry, for example, forestry visit in Langkawi. Okay. And, then actually Dr. Chiam can actually reply and append a document that's in there. So so let's say, for example, I'm going to use okay, so let's use the same file here. So this is the file that we are going to upload. Okay. So you can actually attach, upload from the computer. Okay, and downloads. Okay, so that is the file being shared with the Teams. Okay, and then say please use this. Okay, so then it becomes a conversation where you go through the work with your members within the department. Then you can see here, Dr. Cham has already actually then signed it off. I mean, acknowledge that she has received the file. She can actually use this file by herself, okay, and you can actually also upload the files actually here. So this is actually a file that is being uploaded. So then of course when you work with the document or with the post that you have in here, you can do a number of things. So let's say for example you want to make an announcement, okay. So curriculum review notice. Okay. Then of course you can date for the deadline, okay. Deadline for the submission to MQA is on, let's say for example, 5th of July. Okay, so you can actually hear I am, so let's say for example I'm the dean. So let's say I am signing, okay, the, who else is in here? So, and okay, so let's say to lead the process. Okay, so after I send this, what will happen is that Dr. Hasbullah is going to actually receive this message if he downloads and use the Office Teams on his phone. Okay, so you can actually download and install Office Teams application in your phone, and it becomes what you call it will come up with a notice that says you have a new message. It's similar to WhatsApp, okay, and then it gives proper announcement to the people right away. Okay, you can also not mention not someone but a channel. Okay, so let's say for example so we have what channel in here? So we have, okay, School of Farming. So let's make an announcement to a School of Farming. Okay. So School of Farming. So all the members in School of Farming is going to get this. Please be ready to have a visit from UNESCO, for example. So everybody in the School of Farming is going to receive this message. So that is how you create messages inside the Teams, not just as a conversation, but you can also use it as announcement. You can actually change this to only you and moderators can apply. Reply. So that means if, for example, faculty of agriculture is really, really big, we have 120 staff. So, and you don't want people to jam the conversation with messages. So you can actually select the recipient, the people who can actually reply to the message. And it can also be as, and what you can do here, so you can do undo and also repeat typing, and you can put in, you can make it into a rich text formatting in the posting. Okay, so you can also, you also have, for example, emojis. You put in emojis here. Okay, you can also put GIFs. Okay, so you can search for the GIFs, for example, let's say facepalm. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. Okay, and send it. So there's quite a lot of things that you can do. It can also, although it's a departmental thing, it can be some sort of a fun thing, isn't it? When you do that. So okay, so that is enabling the emojis and also the stickers. Here I actually already have enabled forms. So remember when I asked you about the poll on when to have the meeting, either today or on Wednesday. So I use it, I created using a poll. So just type in a question. Okay, so when is the best date for the faculty meeting, for example? Okay, okay, and then you can put in okay, Monday, and then Tuesday. Okay, and it becomes a poll that people can answer. So then once you send, everybody in the faculty will receive the poll, and then the poll can be answered. Okay, so so that is how we enable and use emojis. And another thing that you can do, if for example, when you are discussing here, okay, you can actually reply with meet now. So meet now is actually like a impromptu meeting that you created without having needing to assign it or creating it in your calendar. So you can actually click on the meet now. Of course, we cannot do that because I'm on a call right now with you guys. So you can actually click on meet now, and it will create a meeting between everybody that's in the discussion, and you can add people and stuff. So so those are the kinds of things that you can do. So of course you have a different other options that here, and you can actually add an application that is available. So if you click on more apps, so these are the things that you can add. For example, okay, let's try image. Okay, let's add image there. Okay, so let's add image. So let's say it's a faculty of agriculture. So let's say cows. Okay. Yeah, dairy cows. Yeah, so you can add image. So just by adding applications in there. So it's quite cool that we need to create a separate channel for livestock department. So, and the image that you sourced from the internet is actually a copyright free image, because you just search it in Bing. Okay, so that is what you can do with this the posts or the conversations within the teams, and it can work for the departments, academic departments, it can work for the administration department, it can also work for the research group. You can also have different teams for classes, for example, and you can share images to your students using this. Okay, so those are the settings for the discussion, and of course, remember, I'm going to show you because I see that some people have their image, some people don't have their personal image in the Teams, and the way to actually change that is by going to your personal name. So what you do is, this is on the top right hand corner is where you change. Okay, so here, of course, I have my picture already. So if you don't have picture right now, so what I would suggest to you is next to your name, underneath your name, click on change picture, okay, and then upload the picture. So when you upload the picture, it will upload a picture that will be updated in all of your Office 365. And I think it's quite important that you have your own profile picture, especially sometimes with the class. Okay, students, we don't really remember them by name, isn't it? And the best way for us to know, okay, this is this person, is by actually looking at pictures. So then you can actually match, okay, this picture or this face belongs to this name. So I would strongly suggest that everybody please change your profile picture with your own picture. Don't use the picture of your goldfish or your cat or whatever superhero that you like. Please use your own picture so that then people would recognize that this is actually you. Okay, so please take the time. I'm going to give you about 2 minutes, okay, to upload your picture. Okay, so we're going to have a break for 2 minutes, and then when we come back, I expect that people are already sharing their pictures, or at least some of you would have uploaded their pictures. I know like Dr. Chiam has already uploaded their picture, Dr. Farid has also shared his picture, Dr. Ainoriza also have her profile picture properly in the Office 365. But for the rest of you, if you still doesn't have your profile picture, use these 2 minutes to upload your picture. Okay, so I'll see you again in 2 minutes. Okay, so we are back. Hopefully you've already uploaded your picture. Of course, sometimes systems may take 1 or 2 hours to reload and refresh your picture. So in the meantime, hopefully you'll be able to upload your profile picture and update your profile picture. Okay, so now it's for me to rest a bit and for you to actually do some work. Okay, so what I want you to do, okay, so since I've already created the themes, okay, and also shared with you the how you can create themes and how you then manage and do the themes, okay. So so this is a simple exercise. So we have I'm going to give you until so it's 3:23 now. So let's say I'll give you until 20 minutes to 4 to create a teams and add members. So it can be a team site for your faculty, it can be team site for your department, it can be a team site for your research group or your class, and whatever. So and what I want you to do is I want you to add several members to it and determine suitable roles for them. Okay, so for example, we have Encik Azbullah here. So Encik Azbullah, you can actually create a team site for the DNCA office. Okay, we also have who else? We also have Encik Naufal here is also here. So Encik Naufal can create a team site for Faculty of Dentistry, for example. Dr. Peter can create a departmental site for URP. Okay, and who else? And for example, if for example Dr. Aino has a research group that you are managing, you can create a research group teams for you between you and your PhD students. Okay, Dr. Ng can create a team for whatever that you do in Faculty of Languages. So let's say you want to create a teams for your department or teams for just for doing a single work in the department. Like let's say for example you are doing your curriculum review, so you can create a teams for the curriculum review, and you can set up any kind of teams that you would like to create. I'm giving you until 20 to 4 start off your teams. Don't worry about adding me into the team. So this is just for you. You may want to continue working on it with your department members or your research group members or with your faculty members later. So don't worry about sharing it with other people. Just create a teams and try and add a few people in there. Okay. Remember, you can always use the Office 365 account of all your department members or your research member or your research students. Even you just type in a few letters in their names and then it will come out the names of the members. For example, Dr. Chiam may have a few students that she wants to manage the FYP or final year project, so she can create a teams for just for that purpose. And then what she do is create a channel for 2020 student, and then create another channel for 2021 student, and then every year you just add a few channels, and then after 3 or 4 years, if you don't use the channels for people from 2019, you just delete the teams. So, so it's up to you to create your teams. Okay, I'll give you until 3:40. Okay, if you have any questions, just fire away. So you can ask your question either from the chat, or you can ask directly here. Okay, so I've got a question from Dr. Shiba. So Dr. Shiba would like to know whether there's any way to add all the students from one class in one go. Okay, you can actually do it from systems side, but you can also create a Teams code to add the student, to invite the students that then they can join with the code. Okay, so what you do is, okay, let me share the screen for that. So I'm going back to our Department of Faculty of Agriculture. Okay, so hopefully you can see this screen now. Okay, so in the Teams that we have, okay, so if you go to the three dots here, more option, click on manage team. Okay, so we have members, pending request, channels, and settings. So in settings, what you do is you click on settings, and then you click on generate. Okay, so generate. So what it says is share this code so people can join the team directly. You won't get join request. So by generating the code, so in this case F8MMKP6, so it's generated randomly. The users that you want to add into your teams, for example your students, can input this code into the teams page. So remember when we click on join, you have join team with the code. So what the students do is they will just type in the code, and then the students will be able to log into the teams themselves. So that is how you create a join link for join code for the students. So you don't have to manually add your students one by one. Okay, so you get them to enroll themselves into your teams. Dr. Chiam has kind enough to share with us several teams that she has created before. So if you go to the chat, then you can see some of the teams that she already have created, probably already a long time ago, Dr. Chiam, or was it very recently? Okay, Cik Azbullah is asking how to reply to existing message chat. Is it meeting chat or is it the post in Teams? So, yeah, the answer is given by me one. You can actually type somebody's name to mention somebody's name. For example, I mentioned somebody's name, so I mentioned Dr. Faris' name. Hopefully, he's still listening. Okay, so you have another 4 minutes to create your teams and add your members. So don't worry about sharing it with us. If you would like to share it with us, then it will be very, very good. One more person, Dr. Elsa, shared her teams, and she's in the Faculty of Agriculture. So of course, after we finish the program, I'm going to delete the Faculty of Agriculture because we honestly don't have Faculty of Agriculture in UM. I think we used to have it some donkey years ago, but since UPM was created, I think we closed our Faculty of Agriculture. That's the story, I think, because I did remember people from UPM telling me that UM used to have a faculty of agriculture back in the 70s. So remember Dr. Shiba asking us about the Teams code, and I tell them about the Teams code. Dr. Shiba, you need to actually make sure that you get the students to log in with their Siswa 365 mail, because students also get the same mail. So ours is um365.um.edu.my. Student is actually siswa365.um.edu.my. Okay, so we have one more minute. so that then we can continue. Okay, so let's continue with the session. Where is my share? Where is my shared page right now? So okay, all right. So you should be able to see my slides again. Okay, so. Let's move on to another feature in your SharePoint, also in your Teams, which is SharePoint. So what is SharePoint good for? SharePoint is actually good to manage your course files. You can collaborate on your faculty and also departmental work. Okay, what SharePoint do, it manages content, files, knowledge, and also application. So the tagline is to empower teamwork. Okay, so I'm going to share an example of my department's SharePoint. So this is actually the building surveying department's SharePoint. Of course, this is going too fast. Okay, so this is actually a folder within the building surveying department, which is my folder, so documents within this SharePoint. So this is the SharePoint of my faculty, my department. So what we do here is collaborative work. You can actually see in the documents, the modified by is from different people. So these are all different faculty members actually creating the document within the SharePoint environment within Office 365 to do certain things. So Dr. Noor Suzaini is working on the PISA documentation, and we work on that PISA documentation together as a department within the SharePoint environment. So nobody actually creates files in their laptop or PC and then upload it to or share it to with using email or whatever. Everybody actually create the document within the SharePoint site, and we work on it together. So we have our curriculum review document here. So so these are the work. So this IFMA is a and the accreditation bodies, and somebody else is working on it. So Dr. Shani is working on that, and we have a staff CV that Dr. Nick is actually managing. So we have different ways of we have different avenues to actually create the SharePoint. And what's best with Teams is that you can actually create the SharePoint for the Teams automatically. Okay, it will be created automatically for you. I will show you later. Let me go through this presentation first. Okay, so these are again, so this is another example. So this is my other department, which is edX. I even put in edX logo here, and also here building surveying department's logo. So we have I can upload the logo, and then so to make it a little bit more personalized. And then we work on the documents within the SharePoint environment with our Office 365 account. So we have people from different names here. Actually, these are folders. So if you go in, then there'll be files in there that we share together. It is not just limited to Office files. You can also upload PDF. You can also upload any type of file. A video file, for example, an audio file, you can actually upload and keep in the SharePoint and in your Office OneDrive. So remember, you have one terabyte of space in your OneDrive. So you can keep any type of file in there. It's not limited to just the office files. Okay, so it's not just PowerPoint, Word, whatever office suite. You can actually put in PDF in there. You can put in WMV or whatever format that's out there. You can just store it there, so it becomes a storage. But of course, in our department, in EdEd department, what we do is we upload and share like Word file reports to TNCA, our proposals, our presentations. So you don't have to ask people to please email me the presentation so that then I can present it somewhere. Everything is on the document SharePoint. So what you do is just go in, pick up the file, and then present it. If you have online, you have internet connection wherever you are, for example in India, in a conference or anywhere. Okay, so SharePoint is actually quite simple. But actually, what you can do is if you look at the format on the left hand side, you have homes, you have notebook, you have calendar, you have pages, site content, and recycle bin. I'm going to show you a feature with it, when I do the live demo. Is you can create a home page for the SharePoint. Okay, for example, you the Faculty of Agriculture just now, you can create a home page, an internal home page for the Faculty of Agriculture using the SharePoint. That means you have a page where you can share news on it, you can share pictures, and you can do a few more things. And it becomes a website especially for you. For example, let's say my research group. Okay, so I can actually create a research group website, internal website, that members from the research group can get certain information from that website or that site within SharePoint. So that is what I'm going to show a little bit later. Okay, so let's work on the live demo again. So what I'm going to show now is how we open the Teams SharePoint site, and then also working with files and also sharing files, and look at the real-time collaboration. Okay, so actually the real-time collaboration has been shown just now with the Word file. Okay, so let's look at the live demo. So let me change the screen. Okay, so let's go back. So this is the Faculty of Agriculture UM that we've created just now. So we have the general, we have the School of Farming, we have the School for Forestry, okay. And I'm going to set up the SharePoint site in the general. So that means everybody in the department or in the faculty will be able to work on the SharePoint site, okay, and also files. Okay, so in the Faculty of Agriculture, in the general channels, so general means everybody. So in the general channels, if you click on files, okay, so these are the files for the faculty. Okay, you can actually put in a folder, for example. So let's create. So this is Kaplan review 2020. Okay, create a folder, and I can, for example, add create a new Excel. Okay, so this is whole learn mapping. Okay, so just create a dummy file. So this is a file for the old curriculum mapping. So old curriculum mapping from 2017 to 2019. Okay, and let's put in a few quotes here. So, okay. So let's just, okay, so for example, so that is a document that we create in our documents in the, okay, so we have the folder, okay, and then you have the so let's go back. So in general we still have that the old document, so that should be enough as a demo. Okay, you can also upload it from your PC. Okay, it can be a file or it can be a folder. Okay, you can also then download the document. Okay, so let's look at what we're going to do today is looking at the Teams SharePoint site. Okay, so remember we created this faculty just now. Okay, and the faculty right away in the files will have this enabled. Okay, so what you do is you click on opening SharePoint. Okay, let me close the other tabs. Let's open. Okay, so this is the documents that is already in Teams just now. Remember we created that document this just very a few seconds ago, so it's already there. So in the documents is where then you work on the file. So and you here again when you create a Word document, okay, so let's say for example okay, so save it. So let's give it the name files. Okay, so let's refresh that. Okay, so automatically the file is created in our Faculty of Agriculture SharePoint, which would actually, when we refresh, would be mirrored in the Microsoft Teams. So there you go. So the file is already created. So you create it just once in the SharePoint, either in Teams, in the files in the Teams, or in the SharePoint, and it will automatically update it. So that is file sharing. So and you can actually work with the files. Now somebody from the department can actually go in and work on the file either in Teams or in SharePoint, and right away the updated version is going to be available online for everybody to see. Okay, so that is what the department or the group or the Teams SharePoint does. So it actually synchronized those two. What I wanted to show you also is actually this home. Okay, so home by default it will give you something like this. Okay, so you have the file, the activity here, and then you have the news you can add. But from what I've learned from the Microsoft team that's coaching me for the last few weeks, you can actually edit this document. Okay, edit this page and to add few things in there. So let's say for example I'm going to show you a few things that I've tried with my existing groups, okay, or existing teams. So this is the SharePoint that I have created for the ATM Rasmus Plus project. Okay, so I updated the website to look somewhat like this. So although it's quite crude or rudimentary, but you get what I mean. That means you can actually update, or you can actually customize the home for the SharePoint site. And you can share this with members of the university. For example, if you want to impress the or you want to showcase your UTM ATM Erasmus project for the whole university to see, then you can actually update the page so that then people can will be able to see what is the program, what is the work that is being done at the department and at the SharePoint. Okay, so let's go back to the Faculty of Agriculture. So what you do to change that, you can actually click on edit. Okay, oh okay, so actually Elsa is working on it. So Elsa, would you mind saving the republish the page, please, so that I can show a demo on the to the group. Okay, while she's doing that, I'm going to play around in there. Okay, so there are a few things that you can do. First, you can do something like this. So this is actually when you click here, it will take you to not this one. This it will take you to the picture. When you click on the link here, it will take you to UM's website. Okay. You can also add tweets. You can also do like a clock, a time down, a countdown like this. Okay. So the way to do it is by clicking on edit. Now you are free to add, okay, a few things. So you, there are a few things that you can add. So let's say first I want to add a layout. So one column. Let's say I'm going to find an image, and you can get image from sites. Okay, can do web search. So let's say backgrounds. I'm going to pick one background. So let's say the background is that one, okay. So I'm going, and you can actually set. So this is already set to Creative Commons, so you don't have to worry about the copyright. Okay, so select that one, open. So this is something that I sometimes like to do. I like to create actually banners for the whatever page that we have. So I'm going to close that. Okay, so I'm going to edit this. So of course I want to then, so let's say I'm going to type here, so this is a website for Erasmus Plus. Okay. So, all right. Then, of course, I'm going to crop this a little bit. Okay, so it becomes a banner. Okay, and then I'm going to save that. And so closing this, we publish. Okay, so now you have a banner for your SharePoint site. Neat, isn't it? So let's add a few more things. So this one is a clock that I added. So again, click on edit. Okay, so let's go back to Faculty of Agriculture, and hopefully, Elsa is still working with Elsa. Elsa, you can play with the Faculty of Agriculture's SharePoint. I'll do it here. Okay, so let's create another clock. Okay, let's add. So what you do is you just click on plus if you want to have a section. So a section can be, so this is a 2x2 section, that means side by side. You can have a different sizes of section, or you can actually edit this section. So let's edit this section actually. So edit section. So instead of two similar columns, I want to make the column on the right smaller. Okay. Okay, so it will become like this. So it's slightly looking much better. Okay, and I want to add. So if you scroll down, so you see the plus sign at the web part. So click on add. So I'm going to add another clock. Okay, so countdown timer. So the title will be, so this is next meeting. So this is project ending. Okay, so project endpoint. Okay, project endpoint, and you want to change the project endpoint. So this project is going to actually finish in 2022 in April. Okay, on the 30th of April. So let's put it as 12 a.m. Okay, so that's it. So then you can add a decision. This will be the time the project ends. Okay, and we publish. Okay, so now you have two clocks. One, you have the clock for next meeting, and you also have the clocks for the project endpoint. Oh, let's put in a picture. So how do you put in picture here? So what you do is, again, click on edit. So I have a picture here on top, so I want to have a picture here as well. So edit this. Okay, add background image. OneDrive. Oh, sorry, web search. So let's put in sunset. Sunset. Nice for project ending clock. Okay, so let's get this looks nice. So open it. Okay, so that's the project endpoint. You can actually change the opacity. Change the overlay color, so you can play with it. So I'm going to go with that. So republish. So you have a clock. So you can actually put in a few more. You can actually put in new section. So for example, if you want to get new section in, so what you do is click on add new section. So this section is going to be a vertical section. So I've never tried this before. What is vertical section? Oh, okay. So vertical section will be a section that sits just on the side. Okay. So probably suitable for long things. So let's say, for example, I'm going to go with a, so you can actually scroll down, but I'm going to go with, let's say, image gallery. Okay, so image gallery, then you can actually upload image. So I've actually downloaded a few images here. So this is actually from a different project. I'm just going to play around with it. We'll delete this later. Okay, so open. So these are going to be the image that I'm going to add. Okay, so now we have pictures on the side, and then when you republish, okay, so you have a site with pictures on the side, and then you have the banner on top, you have tweets here, you have the next meeting and project endpoint, and then you also have the link to UM's website. And of course, you can actually add the documents. So this is documents that we added. So that is how you create the site for the page. And it's useful when you have a site, is that then you'll be able to actually share the work that you do in your digital project or in your faculty or in your department. So it becomes a focal point for people to go in. For example, if you create a faculty or a department website, then the students from the website, the students will be able to get access to the latest information, what will be our latest tweets for, and then it becomes something that's that we showcase to our users. And that is something that I think would be very useful for us as the team that creates the site, and also for people who from inside the organization to look at what we are doing. Okay, so that is what the site is for. I'm actually still fiddling around with the site. Of course, this is a private group. You can actually, I have not explored how you can share this site to a larger group, I would say. Maybe somebody from Microsoft can jump in and help me out. So how do you can, how can you actually share this site with people from outside, for example? Johnny or Amir or Maywan, can you say something about this?
Sorry again, Doctor, your question is sharing the forms to?
Sharing the SharePoint site to, so where can you actually share the SharePoint site that you've created?
You mean to external party?
Yes, for internal or external parties.
Okay, because there is under the site setting, there is Johnny, are you here?
Yeah, sorry, I'm trying to find my unmute mic. I can't find it. Okay, so Doctor, actually from your page here, right, you should able to see 11 members. Do you see that?
Yes.
Yeah, you try to click on the 11 members. I believe you should able to add the members, because this is not a so-called manual site you create directly from SharePoint. It's actually a site that created from the Teams, when you actually create the Teams. So you need to add the members from here. But when you add members, right, automatically they will become a members inside this SharePoint and also Teams. Okay, just for information. So can you try click on the add members? You should able to add the people over here. So if let's say that when you add in the members and you found that, hey, I actually cannot add outsiders, then there's some setting that need to be done from the admin part, which is they need to allow that the site to be allowed to share to the outsiders.
Okay. Yeah. We actually have enabled that. Mm-hmm. So guests can actually become a member.
Okay.
To any teams in UM.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay.
They join with their organizational email. So that means if they are from UPM, they need to use their UPM email. If they are from UKM, they need to use their UKM email, and so on.
See. Okay. So okay, this is the thing. Because actually this is what happened to Maywan last few days when she was trying to share something that from the SharePoint files or the Teams file to the outsiders, but she cannot do that. So for you to do that, right, actually there's a setting that you need to get the admin to do, which is we call allow them to allow them to share to the outsiders. So this one can be done in the SharePoint site only, which is a SharePoint admin.
Okay.
So in the SharePoint admin, they need to move, they need to go to the active site, and then after they select the site, they need to change the sharing permission to anyone.
So if for example if we list a file in our SharePoint site, will the guests be able to see the file?
Yes, they will.
Okay. So then there will not be something that I would suggest.
Because the reason why currently your SharePoint is linked together with your Microsoft Teams, right? Yes. So actually, all is related. So to avoid that kind of issue, right, privacy is whatsoever, we yes. recommend that you use another SharePoint site to do the sharing to the outsiders. To secure your files.
All right. So that means I can create a separate SharePoint for that.
Yeah. Of course, you can.
Okay. All right. Understood.
Okay. And by the way, Doctor, I yes. found that actually your left hand side, the we call quick launch, is still showing then. Do you want to get rid of that?
How do I do that?
Since everyone's here, you can try to go to your setting.
Is it the gear button?
Yep, the gear button. And okay. you go back to the site content again.
Site content, all right.
And then go to the site setting on the right hand side here. Another gear button. Yep. Right. You see here there's a navigation element.
Okay, yes.
Yep, click on it and you uncheck this one, enable quick launch, and you click OK. All right, after that, you click on the icon, the UE icon on the left hand side. You will go back to the home page. You should be able to see.
Okay.
Right.
Oh, all right.
So it's more beautiful.
Yes. Yeah. Now it looks like a website.
Yeah. Okay. Right.
Okay. So, so that is how you create a site. For the moment now, it's only internal. But internal is actually quite good nonetheless, because then you will be able to show your progress, for example, your research project or your department or your research group visually, and also share important and also useful information to the members of the site. Okay, thank you for the help just now. All right, so so I've shown you how we open the Teams SharePoint becomes a site, and then I've also looked at how we work with files, and when we share files, how do we do that? So that translates as a real time collaboration that we have with our members within the Teams environment, and that I think is beneficial to our organization in UM. So that then we work efficiently as possible, either with the larger department members, or it can be with you, with your students. So you can, if you have a class SharePoint, then you can share really nice visual information with the students. So that is how you use the SharePoint. Remember, it is linked to the Teams, so you can create Teams, and then with the Teams, it will create SharePoint for you. But at the same time, you can create SharePoint just for the sake of SharePoint, so you doesn't have to link with the Teams. And to do that is actually, if you go to your Office 365 account, okay, so let's go to your Office 365 account. Okay, what you do is you just create a SharePoint. So you create a SharePoint from the SharePoint site itself, and it will ask you whether you want to have a team site or you want to have a communication site. And what we did just now is actually a communication site. So it says here, publish dynamic, beautiful content to people in your organization. So that is how you create the communication site. And and I think that is something that is people should try and do, okay, so that then they can share information and engage guests visually, okay, about your events or your projects. And it can be something that a small project that you have, then you don't have to go to PTM to ask, so I need to create this site for this project that I have. Probably you have a small community project that you wanted to showcase, so just create a communication site. So that is how you work with Teams and also with SharePoint. So yes, I'm going to close it. Okay, so I actually have a member of a few SharePoint again, so this is a student's thesis. This is a outbound summer program that we have. Okay, although it's 2020, we actually canceled this because of the COVID-19 situation. So don't worry, we're not going to LGMU and get COVID-19 from there. And we also already have the EDEC, you know, so the building surveying SharePoint that I've created just now. This is a group created by Dr. Amira, I believe. I'm hoping that she will actually close this, because we already have our SharePoint, and I've already created a link this SharePoint to our existing teams. Okay, so let's go on and change the view again. So I'm going to share you. So we've looked at SharePoint, we've looked at the demo on the SharePoint and how that relates to Teams and what the SharePoint does and what Teams does. And at our department level, we work on our SharePoint at the SharePoint, because it's much more, I would say, visually simpler. So we work on the documents on the SharePoint in the department. But at the same time, you still have the Teams element that you can actually work from that. So you can have that conversation with your team members. So the second exercise that I'm going to give you, okay? So now it's your turn again. So what I want you to do is I want you to set up a customized team SharePoint in your groups. Remember, you already created the Teams site just now when I gave you time from 3:20 to 4:20. So I've created, so you have created the Teams. Okay, so now what you need to do is you need to go to the SharePoint of your Teams. Remember, to do it is by going to, so let me share that again. So by going to your Teams, okay, and then click on files, okay, and then click on open in SharePoint, just that. So once you click on the open in SharePoint, you will be taken to your Teams site, okay, like this. And then what you do is, so remember just now, you can get rid of this by going to site settings. Or let me remember, site settings, site contents, okay, site settings, and navigation elements, and I need to uncheck enable quick launch, okay, so make it full page, okay, Faculty of Agriculture, okay, so of course, Dr. Elsa is working on the editing on the page, so I cannot do anything. But then what you in your own SharePoint, so what you do is you click on edit, okay, and then you can start editing. Okay, so let's see whether I can wrestle the, yeah, okay, so I actually wrestled the control from her. So I can go in and edit. And then, of course, what you do, you can add elements in there. First, you add a section, and then you populate the section with things that you want to put in. For example, you can put in text, you can put in a link, okay? You can put in, okay, let's say, I want to show you again, so let's put in a link to, let's put in a link to UM, so www. Okay. So that is a link, and so it becomes so what when you want to change anything, just click on edit and then start changing. Okay? So I'm going to give you up until, again, 4:45 for you to play around with the settings. Okay, so So if you need to go to the toilet, for example, you can go to the toilet. But we are going to let you play around with the SharePoint site in your Teams. Okay. If you have any questions, again, just shoot. We will be able to. We will answer the questions whenever you have them. Okay. So up, over to you guys, and start customizing your SharePoint site. It looks like a few of us have issues with creating their SharePoint site. We will start up soon. Is asking about the countdown clock. Yeah, so if you click on the pen icon next to the countdown clock, you should be able to edit it. You can change the dates, put in the background picture. So has anybody been able to create a SharePoint site? And if you could like share your screen and show what have you done in your site, that would be nice. Okay, we have 5 more minutes. So if you wanted to share, any of you wanted to share your SharePoint site, just click on the share button. And you can see 1 or 2 prototypes. Congratulations, Dr. Ng Li Luan. You managed to create a site. Nice, countdown to CC or MTO. Lin Huimin. She said her SharePoint. So, as you can see, I'm also playing with the SharePoint site for Faculty of Agriculture. So I managed to add Twitter feed, map here. And so this is actually, what was it? Just now I used, I think it was a call to action. Dr. Dani, can you share your SharePoint site? Any of your SharePoint site? Do you have any?
Still working on it, lah, Dr. Zai.
No, just share the work in progress. Dr. Amira, do you have anything to share?
Sorry, Dr. Zahe, not yet.
So Dr. Chiam has already shared her. Nice. So it becomes a website for the student. Okay. So we are on track to finish by 5, which is very good. And I see that people are... Oops, that's the thunder. So, of course, with the SharePoint site and with the numerous things that you can put in, the numerous website web parts that you can put in, you can of course play around with what we have here: document library, a divider, hero, so in Kindle instant preview, which is nice, quick chat. So I actually haven't tried most of it yet. Only a few. So you can put in YouTube, you can put in weather, even Trello is there. So there's quite a lot of things that you can do, quick links. And of course I shared just now image gallery. So and I think there will be additions to this in the future, if I'm not mistaken. work clock is quite impressive, I think. If, for example, you are working on an international project, so you put in work clock in the on the face of the SharePoint site, so that then you know what time is it for your partners in, for example, Norway or the UK or in New York. So that will be also useful. If you have a Trello, and a few more. So so I think that's about what I can actually show you up until this point. So Peter is asking how to add work clock. So what you do is you click on the plus sign, click on that plus sign, and then just find world clock. Yeah, so just type world and then you can click on world clock. Of course, what you do is you add a location. Let's say, for example, London, and then put in New York, and then put in, let's say, Abu Dhabi. So yeah, so that's world clock. Really nice. So just republish. Okay, and then you got your work clock. Okay, so I think that is the training part of this workshop. Hopefully that has been useful for everybody. I also had fun doing it and exploring a bit more new things with the help of the team from Microsoft. So I think we move on to the next section, which is a Q&A section. So I think I can switch or give the floor to Mei Wan to proceed and also conclude our session today.
Okay, Dr. Zahir, thank you very much for your time for this 2 hours plus on the workshop. It's very interesting, and I see your participants are actively actually participate on this SharePoint especially. I believe that it's not easy, but they try, and I'm happy to see the result. They're actually able to do it. It's really very amazing. Okay, the next part, I think we still have about 15 minutes. Would you want me to, is there any Q&A from the participants that you would like to ask verbally to Dr. Zahir? Because some of you that chat in the message, I think we have already addressed. Would you want to voice out, or is there any comment that you would like to actually talk to Dr. Zahir on these today's sessions regarding to Microsoft Teams and also SharePoint?
Yes, and of course, if anybody have questions that on the technical side, people from Microsoft will be able to answer it straight away.
Okay. So I have actually prepared a feedback form. So for today's, we will need everyone to do a feedback for today's sessions from Dr. Zahir. Besides from that, I'm not sure, Dr. Zahir, have you informed them that regarding to the badge that we are giving out for this group of people that participate in the pilot test?
I haven't gone to that yet. You haven't told me about the badge yet.
Yeah, okay. The badge actually, we will post, from Fidelis, as a reward to your staff participation on the pilot test. We will produce it's a collar pin. It's a metal collar pin that we'll give to every individuals who join this pilot test group. So we will need your attendance as a confirmation for us to count on the quantity as well. So what to do is we will actually put out the feedback form in the chat shortly. So you just click in and you just fill up your details and your feedback.
So that will be the attendance.
We will count that as attendance. Yes. Okay. And also after this, because we believe that today's for some of you might be the first time or you are not so familiar yet, maybe we will actually get Dr. Zahir to get another feedback 2 weeks later. So it's actually for you to keep track on your group of participants, whether they actually try the all the tools that you have showed them. So whether they can apply back to their daily operations. And then from there, we will get some feedback from all the participants through Dr. Zahil. So on week 5 or week 6, Dr. Zahil, we will get you another form just to distribute to your group of pilot test group so that they can actually fill up their feedback to you. And you see, if you see, we can actually help you to address it accordingly. Okay, Atira, were you able to share the feedback form link in the chat?
Yeah, okay. All right, shortly, one moment, yeah.
And regarding the certificate, Dr. Zahir, I think you asked before, right?
Yes.
For that part, I can't actually promise yet because we need to check with Microsoft. We'll get keep you update on this.
Okay. Okay, hi everyone. I've sent the survey link at the chat, so you all can click on that and then help me to answer the survey. It also actually helps Dr. Zahir to know how you all understand on this training. Thank you.
Dr. Zahir, I will actually get this information, the feedback surveys, I will actually tabulate in Excel. So on the next week meeting, we will share it to you.
Okay. So what about the teacher groups?
Teachers, yes. Previously, you told me that you will select the same group of people from this pilot test, right? Those that are teachers, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so for teachers, we can provide another batch just for teacher. So for teachers who join both sessions, they will get two batch.
Okay. I think since we are already here and you guys are also here, the teachers group are also here. So we would like to invite all the educators, all the lecturers here to also join. So actually, when we pinpoint the people for the teacher group, it's actually not inclusive of everybody. But since quite a lot of the people that we add from different groups or research group, the research also the department group is also lecturers. So if you would like to join the teacher group training, you are free. I think you we would like to invite you to join as well.
Okay, the teachers enablement week is four on week 4, 5, 6. So next week is week 5 for us. So we need to say 2 more weeks later, we will set the date for the next workshop on the teachers enablement. So we will get Dr. Zahir to agree on the date first, then before we confirm. But this is good to attend for all the teachers as we actually cover more area as in the assignments and also the quiz for that we can actually use it in Microsoft Teams. So it's the same platform, just that as additional features, including the classroom notebook, how do you distribute notes to your students, how do you create assignments inside Microsoft Teams, how do you actually mark your homework inside Teams and distribute the result to all your students. And they're also involving like how do you get the interactions and get students to engage with each other in under Teams.
Okay.
How do we join? Some of the participants asked, how do we join? Stay tuned on Dr. Zahir latest updates, perhaps in the Teams, Dr. Zahir?
Yes, okay, yeah. We will inform you with email.
Yes, so it will be similar like today, about 2 hours, two and a half to 3 hours, the similar durations. And for the next week, Dr. Zahir, we will actually continue on the syllabus for teachers enablement. Perhaps you would also want to collect some feedback from your teachers, like what would they like to find out, and then we will actually nail down to some of the scenarios and then to show you how to demo to them.
Okay.
On K7. Atira, how was the feedback response? Are you able to gather?
It's 8 as at now.
Okay.
Yes.
So Dr. Zahir, just wanted to confirm with you on the next meeting. Our next meeting will be on next Monday, same time, 2 to 3:30.
Okay.
I believe the feedback form, if we can able to compile everything by today, by this today or tomorrow, we'll send you in the Teams. Okay. Amir, would you want to add anything else for the next, the following week's module?
For the following week, I think we covered most of the applications already for Doctor. And see how the progress goes along the way. But I see a lot of teachers, lecturers here, participants here is asking a lot of tips and tricks on how to conduct a virtual classroom. I think that one, if during the champions training, we should be covering those things. But for right now, for the test pilot, the objective is really about how to create teams for staff, for educators, collaborate together, and also just now Dr. Zahir show how to create SharePoints. That's really, really literally that is very advanced features, and I'm so fascinated that all of you can follow him. And by time, hopefully, you can easily create and teach other lecturers on how to do on how to use SharePoint and other collaboration tools in Teams. There are lots of collaboration tools such as Planner, even Microsoft Stream. If you know some tips on how to record and edit your video straight away from Stream, yeah, I think this is all. Okay. It's a very good session.
Yeah. Okay. Perhaps some of the teachers, if you are still here, or you can actually write down some of the concerns that you would like to find out for the following sessions, so that maybe we can take note here and what would you like to find out from us on Microsoft Teams. So I see some of you writing, creating virtual class, creating assignment. Or if for those who have, of you who haven't responded or you have any questions, you can also put it up here. We will go through one by one. Linda, would you want to say anything else before we end the sessions?
Yes, thank you, Teams, Fidelis, and also Dr. Zahir for a good job done. Right, Dr. Zahir, you're really lecturing the teachers. I can hear you treating them like students, exactly asking them to do homework, assignment on the spot. I think I like back to school. Okay, but they are very obedient. They really do the homework in class, yeah, online classroom. Yeah, that's good. Okay, there are a lot of functions like Poly and things that we can share with you for doing fun things in online classroom. So next meeting, right, with Dr. Zahir, we will show you some fun activities so that you can make the class more fun, right? Since the teachers are actually very obedient on listening, but we push in more activities, fun games to let them play along. So thank you for the participations, and we hope that by end of this program, this is called a Capstone program. We hope that all these teachers in UM can actually, and the staff as well, can drive the team's adoptions. Okay, because at the back end, we can actually, Microsoft can actually see the adoption drive. And I'm actually eagerly to share with you how is the tremendous changes after Dr. Zahir trained you all. So I think, I believe Dr. Zahir also want to know about this analysis. So drive hard to use Teams in your classroom, so it will have result after the end of the program. So we will show you the result, Dr. Zahir, by end of 8 weeks an analysis report so that it will be a recognition for yourself as well. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. So I'm actually normally that's how I do my trainings, even with staff, even with students. So always hands on, so that then people can actually build up their muscle memory in doing things. So when they click themselves, so they know how to do it. So that's why normally we design, even when we design trainings for staff, we always design it with a hands on approach.
All right. Thanks.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Zahir. Before I stop, I end this, I will post again the feedback link in case some of you actually haven't filled up. We'll post again here at the chat. You guys can always come back here and refer to the link. And if not, Dr. Zahir, I will post it again on the Teams that we are having, so you can actually share to your team member.
Okay,
thank you.
Dr. Zahir? Yes. I hope to see more teacher participations in the teacher enablement pilot test group. So hopefully can achieve 50.
I think we can. I think since we have a group of lecturers here, so they can also
invite their colleagues.
Invite their peers, so that then who wants to join, we will give them the link.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. See you next week.
All right, thank you. Bye.